Hi, this is Jose Luis, and in my previous videos, I was teaching you how to write a WebSocket client using a C# console application. And I was teaching you also how to connect it to the WebSocket server, the Echo WebSocket server that we have been using in the previous videos in this playlist, so that now the C# client can read the information of the position of the ball that we were controlling with the P5 sketch. Now, what I would like to do in this video is to teach you how to take this data that is coming into the client, which is basically a string that looks like a JSON object, but it's not really a JSON object. I would like to teach you how to deserialize that, extract the numbers, and then be able to use those numbers to draw them on the screen or to do something with them. So what we're going to do is I'm going to teach you JSON deserialization in C#. Okay. And the way we're going to do that is very similar to the way we did WebSockets before, which is the fact that C# also has some JSON deserialization capacities by default, but even Microsoft uses libraries to handle that situation, because there is this one very common, very popular JSON library for the .NET framework called JSON.NET, basically. Okay. So what we're going to do is we're going to use this library to deserialize an object and convert it into, for example, a point. So how are we going to do this? Well, same as with the WebSockets library, we could go to the project, we could download it, we could build the DLL, or we could just download the DLL directly from here. Or what we can also do is, because we already have a C# console application, what we can do is we can download that dependency from the NuGet packet manager. So that's what we're going to do right now. So I'm going to right click on the project, C# client, manage NuGet packages. You can see that I already have installed the WebSocket Sharp one. So I'm going to go to browse, and literally you're going to see that without typing anything, the first one that shows up is the Newtonsoft JSON library with almost 1 billion downloads. That gives you an idea of how popular actually this library is. It literally looks like it's the most popular library in the whole packet manager. So we're just going to click here, we're going to click install, and then this library will be become available and be automatically referenced in our project. And then what I'm going to do now is I'm going to bring it in as a dependency. So I'm going to load it in my project by typing newtonsoft.json. All right. And now I have here information. I have here the library, and then I can start using it in my code. So what do I want to do with this library? Well, what I want to do is I want to take e.data, which is just a string that looks like a JSON file, and I want to parse that string and convert it into an object with double numbers that I can use, for example, to represent location in two-dimensional space. So how are we going to do that? Well, there are several ways that we can do that. The JSON library actually has like many, many ways of handling parsing data, converting data, doing it partially, doing it completely, etc. But one of the easiest ways that I have found is taking the information that we want to parse. So for example, in this case, we want to parse the X and Y locations, right? So let me start this over again. We want to parse the X and Y locations. And one of the easiest ways to do this is by taking the whole object and parsing it into a class that has these properties. So if this object is an object that has X and Y properties, and both of those are doubles, then something that I can do is I can just create a class that contains an X property that is a double and a Y property that is a double, and ask the JSON library to take this information and try to stitch it, or to create one object of that class with this information. So let me show you how that is going to look like. First of all, I'm going to stop the program. Then the next thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to create a class that contains those X and Y properties. The way I'm going to do this is I'm going to go right above my program class, and I'm going to type class, and I'm going to give it a name. Because I'm going to be using x and y to represent two-dimensional location, I could call it point, but you know that I'm a bit more, I like calling things vector better, so I'm going to call it vector. And then here I'm going to create a public property, which is going to be of the type double being x, and I'm also going to create another one called y. And what's important is that these two names must match whatever is coming from your JSON object, so that they can be properly serialized. Okay, so now I have a vector class in my program. And then what I would like to do now here is I would like to take the information of eData and try to convert that into a vector object. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a new variable called position. It's going to be of the type vector. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to use the JSON convert class that comes with JSON.NET, with the library. I'm going to use this class that has a lot of methods, deserialize, serialize, object, whatever, blah, blah, blah. I'm going to use the main one, which is called deserialize object. Then what I'm going to do afterwards is I'm going to open and close angle brackets, because deserialize object needs to know which type do I want to deserialize this data to. And that type is going to be the vector class. So I want to take this information and I want to deserialize it into something that looks like a vector. And then in parentheses here, I'm actually going to pass the information that I want to deserialize. That is going to be e.data. All right. Okie dokie. And then let's write something. Console write line. I'm going to create it a vector with it's going to be with I don't know. So p dot so position dot x and then a comma and then position dot y. Okay, so I'm just going to print the two values of this vector to see if things worked. Okay. I think we might hit some errors, and I'm going to explain to you why. So let me try to run this program. I'm going to run this program, and you see that, boom, I get an error right away. So what is happening here? Newtons of unexpected character encounter while parsing value, blah, blah, blah. What does this mean? What this means is that the library encounter a problem converting e.data into a JSON object. And where is the problem here? Well, it turns out that if you remember, when we executed and we connected to the WebSocket server, the first thing that we did was we sent a message saying like, hey, hello from Parametric Camp. So if you see here, the first thing that we have received from the server is not a JSON object. It's just a string message, hello from PCamp, whatever, which cannot really be turned into a JSON object. It cannot be serialized, and that's why the program is throwing an error. So this is a really good practice, because very typically when we're connecting to what we're doing network communication, is very useful to try to be safe and try to prevent things going wrong. Like, for example, someone sending a message that the C# JSON parser cannot convert to a JSON object. So what can we do about this? Well, the first thing that we can do is try to be safe by wrapping all of this, by wrapping the part where we're trying to serialize the JSON object into a try-catch statement. Because try-catch statements, what they do is, if something goes wrong inside of the try clause, then what they do is they throw an exception, but they don't break the program. And they let you handle that error in whichever way you want to do. So let's do that. So I'm going to write here try, and then I'm going to open a close curly brackets. I'm going to move this code all the way here, because this is the code that I think might be faulty, that I want to safe check. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to write afterward catch. I'm going to open parentheses. I'm going to create a variable called exception so that C#, if there is a problem, gives me an exception with data about what is going on. And then here, just for the sake of it, I'm going to, for example, I'm going to write to the console the exception. I'm going to write the error message that I'm getting from the C# executor. And then I'm going to run this, and you can see that now I don't get any error. But what I get is the error written here, dump into the console. You see, unexpected character encounter while parsing, blah, blah, blah. This is exactly what I had before in the error. It's just that my program has not broken. So I'm safe proofing my program for unexpected data coming in from the server, which is a really, really good practice. So I'm going to make this a little nicer. I'm not going to dump the whole error on the console. What I'm going to do is, instead of writing that, what I'm going to write is a message saying, I don't know what to do with, I'm going to escape a double quote, and then e.data, and then I'm going to escape another double quote here. All right. So if I now run this program, you can see that what happens is I received from the server the hello from pcamp message, but then the error message is, I don't know what to do with this string hello from parametric camp. All right. The program is safer now, but let's see if it works with the JSON that we created before, the JSON parser. So now I may have to restart this. So I'm going to reconnect here. And then I'm going to move here, move here, move here, and I should be getting, oops, sorry. Yeah. So I halted, I stopped the program from executing when I was selecting all these texts. So let me, you see, received from the server the JSON object, and I created a vector with these two coordinates. And then I'm creating the vector, the vector, the vector. So it looks like it's working. I am able now to create a vector object that has these two values, which is great, because now this is data. So the position vector is now data that has double information, that has numbers, and that then I can use for and in any workflow, in any algorithm, in any program, in any code that I want to write in my console application. Okay, so that was parsing JSON data that is coming from a server, which is something that is a very, very common. JSON objects are a super, super standard format for exchanging information between processes, especially over the internet and over network communication. So now what we're going to do is, in the next video, I'm going to, just for fun, I'm going to do a little example where I'm going to take this position and I'm going to use that to draw a nice ASCII square on my terminal with a small canvas and with the dot changing in position depending on where what information we get from the server. So, I mean, this is the fun with WebSockets playlist, so we should get some fun, right? Anyway, on top of that, if you like what you saw, please consider maybe liking this video, subscribing to the channel, pushing that notification button, all those things that help us keep the message going. All right, so let's do some fun ASCII art with this. Let's do it.